deep all over Corregidor, and when you stepped on them, it was like stepping on a pile of cornflakes. It was a crunchy sound.
After 11 days of bitter combat, the American assault force has captured almost all of Corregidor. But the ROC has one more trick to play. The last Japanese troops have fortified an old American bunker on a ridge called Monkey Point. Paratroopers call up a Sherman tank to blast in the entrance.
The tank was on top of Monkey Point. Monkey Point went off. The tank went 30 feet in the air. Debris, big boulders, 20 foot long, 3 foot thick timbers were blown way up in the air.
Unknown to the Americans, the bunker is a store for tons of ammunition. The explosion blasts a crater 70 feet wide and 30 feet deep. 54 paratroopers are killed in the Monkey Point disaster and 145 wounded. But nearly 200 Japanese are also killed. And the Japanese resistance on Corregidor is over. The men of the ROC assault force have overcome an enemy three times their strength. But 223 men have been killed and more than 1,000 wounded. Manila Bay is now open to Allied shipping. Supplies are rushed to the troops still battling to capture the last area of the city still in Japanese hands. In Manila, the Japanese have been holding out in the old city, an area known as the Intramuros. Built by the Spanish centuries earlier, it is surrounded by massive ramparts.
The walls, I believe, were 40 feet thick, and we were shelling it with mortars, and the artillery was shelling it, and oh, it was almost completely destroyed.
When gaps have been blasted in the ancient walls, MacArthur's men charge forward. It is a no-quarter fight, using flamethrowers and phosphorus grenades. Everywhere, the horrified Americans find the bodies of massacred Filipino civilians.
As the Japanese were pulling away, many of them would slaughter whatever Filipino civilians they saw. Irregardless of age or male, female, didn't matter. They were just slaughtered.
At last, the Intramuros is captured and its garrison wiped out. When Admiral Iwabuchi hears the news, he commits ritual suicide. His last men die in the smoking rubble of his headquarters. After three long years of Japanese occupation, Manila has been liberated. But General MacArthur declares it to be second only to Warsaw as the most devastated Allied city of World War II. Tragically, Admiral Iwabuchi's men have caused the deaths of 100,000 Filipino civilians. The vital areas of Luzon are now in American hands. Yamashita's surviving troops are hunted into the mountains.
I would say the Philippines can be called the beginning of the end for the Japanese, because now you have the Japanese losing their ability to hold on to what they have.
8,000 Americans have paid the ultimate price for the liberation of Luzon, with another 30,000 wounded. But more than 7,000 Allied prisoners have been saved from certain death, and freedom has been restored to a friendly nation. To symbolize the magnitude of Japan's defeat on Luzon, General MacArthur goes back to Corregidor and watches as the stars and stripes are hoisted once again on the shell-torn flagpole.
And he looked like a kid had just got something for Christmas. He just looked around with the biggest smile on his face. When you can get a five-star general look at you with a smile, I think you've done a good job.